Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. I am the Poverty Princess, and tonight I am making, as promised, banana cake with banana frosting. So yes, once again, I am going bananas for banana cake. In this next clip, I will have everything that you need to make the cake. You can, if you want, add nuts to this cake during preparing the cake batter. Completely a matter of preference. I don't, but I do know some people who do like to add nuts to it. Completely up to you. I prefer it without, but I like my banana bread with. Just a matter of preference, and just wanted to put that out there. So, let's get into baking a really yummy cake. So first, we'll start with 3/4 cup of butter. So I'm using 1 stick, which is 1/2, and 1/4, which is the 4 tablespoons. So I'm just going to open this up and just cut it into small cubes. That's very soft. It has been sitting out here. I apologize for that lapse of what I was doing there for a moment. I didn't expect him to come out, so he totally caused me to lose my train of thought there for a moment. He's going over to the window now anyways. It's humid in here, and that's probably where he's just gonna stay, checking out any late night little critters roaming around. If that makes sense to you, 1 1/2 sticks, since 1 stick is 1/2 a cup. So I have 3/4 cup in here. And now I am going to add my sugar, 1 1/2 cups of sugar. And my measuring cups. Alright guys, this is really weird. Just want to have my measuring cups out here. Okay, so I'm wrong. Alright. That was a Twilight Zone moment. That was where I seriously could have sworn I had them on the table. Okay, very weird. Alright, so I need 1, and 1/2 cups. Okay. just going to break this butter up a little bit. Now I'm going to add my 3 eggs. Again, stirring good. Getting the eggs and butter. Really, really all blended in. Vanilla, and that is a teaspoon. And I'm just stirring that in really, really good. He's laying in the windowsill. He's not interested in what I'm doing. Alrighty, so now 2.5 cups of flour. Yeah, I am referencing my recipe because I haven't made this cake in like 2 years. Actually, I think I made it maybe right after I moved in upstairs, and that will be 3 years in August, so it's been a bit. And for me, it's mostly, I just want to be sure I get my amount of ingredients correct. Especially if it's not something that I make frequently, you might think, oh yeah, it's this instead, and use the wrong measurement, and have a disaster on your hands. So yeah, not good. Alright, so 2.5 cups of flour. And again, just taking my time stirring everything in. Salt, baking soda, and my baking powder. So, a half of a teaspoon. Teaspoon of baking soda and 1 teaspoon of baking powder. So half teaspoon of baking soda. And a teaspoon of baking powder. Yep, I am scraping the sides of my bowl. Okay, I just want to get everything mixed together as good as you can get it. You certainly don't want to waste flour and sugar. Just really want to make sure you have all your dry ingredients really mixed in pretty good. And about now, it's starting to look sort of doughy. But that's okay, that's only for a moment till I add the sour milk. All right, well, before I do that, preheat my oven to 350. Yeah. All right, so now I'm going to add my bananas. So, add them over here so I can just toss the skin into the garbage bag real quick. And like I said yesterday, these are just probably 2 days. If I didn't use these would be really, really bad. So, there's so many good things you can make. When you're faced with 2 or 3 bananas that are just starting to turn, bread, muffins, cupcakes, like, oh my gosh, so many yummy things. So, you're supposed to use a cup to a cup and a half. These three bananas are going to be, you know, roughly a cup and a half. It's not going to hurt if you actually put a little bit extra in. I mean, in my case, I love bananas, so a little bit extra doesn't hurt, you know? And these are so soft. I'm basically just like slice them right through them. Put my spoon like this. Now they are actually blending in really, really good. Your cake batter should look something like that, close to it. All right, so now I'm going to be doing, okay, it's a different, measuring cups in here, but no, they must be over here. Okay. Oh, there it is. Oh, if I ever have a day where I don't have a sinus drip or a tickle, I would be super, super happy, you know? All right, so you need 3/4 cup sour milk. Now I have 1/2 cup of reduced fat, low fat milk in here. So I'm going to add a 1/4 cup of lemon juice in. And I'm gonna stir this around really, really good. See, it's starting to thicken already. So, my sour milk is pretty well thickened up. I'm adding that to my batter. And yeah, my oven didn't beep yet, but melted in here now. All right, so it should, your cake batter should look like this. Should be a nice even banana color, basically. Now, you can use 2 round cake pans to make this cake. I have always made it as a 1-layer cake in a pan like this. It always comes good for me. If you don't feel like greasing and flouring your pan, you can simply line it with wax paper. And that's what I decided to do with this. I'm just putting some wax paper on the bottom. So I just want to make sure that I have it. Evened out in here. Just going to pour my batter right into my pan. I swear I did not hear my oven go off. Now, this usually takes anywhere between 17 to 28 minutes to bake. I'm gonna go, because I haven't made it in this oven before, I'm gonna say about 25 minutes. I'm gonna put this in for guys. It's getting late and I am going to wrap this video up. I'm going to quickly show you how to make my banana frosting. So I have my bananas in here. Usually I use between a half to one cup of bananas. That's probably about a little over a half, maybe like 3/4 cup of banana, and I'm going to add a half teaspoon of lemon juice. And I'm just going to mix this up real quick. So now I'm adding a 1/4 cup of butter, and I'm going to beat this in very quickly. Sugar. freezer bag. And now I'm going to mix it in. Mix it all up really good. So this is what your frosting should look like. And this is pretty thick. So what I'm going to do is pour this onto my cake. Well, some of it. And I'm just going to spread it all over my cake. I know. I shouldn't do that, but that is really, really good, guys. Really good. Alright, so what I'm going to do is put this in the refrigerator and I'm just going to let it chill. I'll do up my little bit of dishes and I am going to bed. By the time you watch this, I will be sound asleep. I have a little bit left. I'll probably just fill in the corner over here and over here. But other than that, this is it. And I'm going to show you quickly how this frosting should look. And as I said, I'm just going to put that in the refrigerator then to chill. And I know when I cut into it today, it's going to be really, really good. I already know because I've made this before. Oh guys, I hope you like this video. If you do, please give it a big thumbs up and hit my subscribe button. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you on the next one. Good night.